What's up, everyone? It's your boy LJ, and in this video I'm gonna talk about the camber squat bar, the buffalo bar, and the straight bar. If you're new to the channel, please make sure to subscribe, and if you like the video, please make sure to show the thumbs up button some love. So I wanted to come on here real quick and just show the differences between the three squat bars that I have. These might be some squat bars that you're looking into. I've been working out with them for a little bit over a month. Some a little bit longer because I've had them for longer. Like the cambered squat bar, I've had a little longer than the buffalo bar. So I have had a little bit more experience with the cambered squat bar. But anyways, I wanted to come on here real quick and just show some snippets, some quick videos on the differences as far as the trajectory, as far as like how it's gonna sit on your back. Again, this is specifically just for squats. So I'm just gonna start with the straight bar because that's obviously the one that we're all familiar with. If you're squatted at all, or if you're a power lifter, this is the one that you're likely gonna start with if you're gonna do squats in general at a commercial gym. And I've been using this bar since what? Back in 2006, 15 years with the straight bar, I haven't had any issues. I never really had any issues as far as like shoulder mobility and whatnot. It does take some getting used to, like just having the weight rest on your back. I'm sure you've seen like the little cushions that they have for the straight bar because it helps alleviate some of that like stress and some of that pain when it does rest on your shoulders. I would say that as I started to increase the weight on the straight bar, that's when I really started noticing just how painful it could be on my back. Again, not saying that I squat a ton of weight, but it's different. I mean, that was likely the first time I ever carried that kind of weight on my back, regardless if it was 95 pounds, 135, and so on and so on. Like, your shoulders don't see that kind of weight just because, you know, you gotta be a little bit extra to be putting that kind of weight on your shoulders and whatnot, just to squat it. I just took a quick video as far as like just squatting with the straight bar from the front angles, where I typically place my hands when I'm squatting with the straight bar, and then some of the side angles too, just so that you can see it and so that you can kind of compare it to what it looks like when you're squatting with the buffalo bar as well as the cambered squat bar. So I mean, not gonna spend too much time on this one. Because again, if you've squatted with the bar, odds are, if you've done it at a commercial gym, odds are that you've used this straight bar. We all know it's a 45 pound bar. Typically this will have knurling in the middle so that it can rest on your back and it won't move around on you as much. Now the buffalo bar is the next bar that I actually recorded myself doing a squat in. I haven't had this bar for too long. I want to say it's been about 2 months, but I did use it for about a month. And to be honest, I'm still kind of getting used to it. Like, again, the squat itself doesn't really change. The trajectory doesn't really change much. You won't really feel it impact you so much while you're squatting and whatnot. I feel like it is meant to resemble as close to squatting with the straight bar as possible. But again, the bar is curved, and this is meant to relieve some stress off of your shoulders. It's supposed to rest on your shoulders a little easier and just more chill, I guess. With that being said, like I've been using the buffalo bar for about a month, and like the first couple of times it did take some getting used to as far as it resting on my back. It was a little bit uncomfortable. I would also mention that the buffalo bar, it is a little thicker in diameter, so it is a little bit more comfortable when it rests on your shoulders, or at least it's supposed to be. Like I said, I'm still kind of getting used to that. The more I use it, the more it's becoming the norm, and the easier it is on my shoulders as far as holding the bar in place. I don't have to reach up as high because it does angle kind of down. Re-racking was a little awkward, and unracking was a little awkward. Because of the curve, I noticed that on my actual J-cups, depending on how I had my J-cups set up, it would kind of flip over and the J-cups would kind of fan out. But after playing with it a little bit, I found the way that works for me. So the J-cups kind of do stay in place now. I am a little bit more cautious when I re-rack it, especially because I work out so early in the mornings. I think just hearing the bar fall over if it's not upright kind of startles me at times, but maybe I'm just jumpy, who knows. One thing that I would mention is that the J-cups are gonna sit a little bit lower than your standard straight bar because of the curve. I mean, you're gonna want to set them a little bit lower to make up for that curve so that you can still have it at the right height to be able to get under it and unrack and then re-rack. So something to keep in mind. Another thing that I will actually keep in mind is that the safety pins or safety straps, depending on what you use, you're gonna wanna set those a little bit lower when you use the Buffalo Bar, because of the fact that the weights do sit a little bit lower. So you're gonna run into the issue where you might actually end up touching the safety straps or the safety pins. Again, because of the fact that the weights sit a little lower. So just things to keep in mind. This particular Buffalo Bar is by Fringe Sport. I will put the link in the description below. And it does weigh 46 pounds. So it is a little bit heavier by a pound, but not a great big difference. Again, I think it's supposed to resemble as close to a straight bar squat as possible. Now, when it comes to squatting with the Camber Bar, this one's by far the biggest difference. Because of pretty much everything, when it comes to the safety straps or safety pins, those definitely have to be super low when you're squatting because of the fact of where the weights sit. If you don't set them up low enough, then there is a tendency to hit them. I have to say that squatting with the Cambered squat bar, I actually really enjoy it. I enjoy it a lot. Setting it up, like as far as your J-cups, like the setup is pretty much the same as a straight bar because it's still a straight bar on top, except for the camber part, obviously. So setting up the J-cup is gonna be the same as a straight bar as far as height goes. Setting the safety straps and the safety pins, those are gonna have to be the lowest that you will out of all three bars, because of the fact that the weight sits so much lower. So keep that in mind when you're setting this up. Everything is a little bit trickier when you're first starting to learn how to use it. Whether it was unracking and getting into place, re-racking, making sure that the weights aren't swinging when you re-rack because you're gonna hit against the squat rack. The actual motion itself, I think like with all of these bars, the motion is not supposed to change. And that's why I love the Cambered squat bar, because if it does change, if you're being sloppy and if you're not keeping tight, then the bar is gonna let you know right away. If you go down for a squat and you're not stable, your base isn't stable, you're not set correctly, you're not keeping tight, then the weights are gonna swing on you. It's gonna be like a pendulum. They're gonna swing on you and it's gonna really throw you off. If you're still kind of just getting the squat motion in general, then using a Cambered squat bar probably isn't your best bet because of the fact that like it's a funky motion to get used to. And again, if you're not keeping tight with your squats, then the weights are gonna swing on you and it could potentially lead to injury because it could make you lean forward and just drag you forward if you're not keeping tight with your up and down motion. But that's actually one of the reasons why I love that bar so much. I love the bar because of that, because it's a constant reminder to keep tight. If I'm going down for a squat and I'm coming back up and I feel it even move just a little bit, it's like a constant reminder like, hey, you're loosening up, keep tight and come up strong. That's a big reason why I love that bar. Now, this bar does give you a bunch of options as far as where to place your hands. I typically place my hands where I would using a normal straight bar. If I'm putting my hands on any other place of the camber bar, like it doesn't feel right for me. It feels a little bit more uncomfortable. But then again, like my shoulder mobility is fine. I don't have that big of an issue. Like I don't have shoulder pain and whatnot. So it's not that big of an issue for me to place my hands where I would a straight bar. But you do have a bunch of options. You can place your hands pretty much anywhere on this Cambered squat bar. And obviously the lower you place the hands to squat with the Cambered squat bar, the less likely that it's gonna swing on you because you're pretty much gonna be holding it in place. So that's an easy way to take care of the swing. Because of where the weight actually sits, you will feel muscles in your legs like just activate more. It'll just target things a little bit different. I'm pretty crappy at explaining this, but in my personal opinion, I feel like my quads are definitely more on fire after using the Cambered squat bar than they normally are otherwise. So just keep that in mind. You're probably wondering like, yo, LJ, why are you only doing 25s on the Cambered bar? Like on everything else, you're doing 45s, but on the Cambered bar, you're only doing 25s. Well, it's because this particular bar, it's from Titan Fitness. Again, I'll put the link in the description below. But this particular bar weighs 85 pounds. So with the 25s on each side, it's still 135. So no, I'm not super weak with this bar, but keep that in mind. You will need less weight when you're using this bar. As you do get onto heavier squats, you will notice that you're not gonna need to load as many plates as you would with the straight bar to kind of get the same effect. Like, you will still feel dunskies and dunzo when you do squat with this bar. So that's also another way in which it's gonna alleviate a little bit of your shoulders. It's because you're not gonna have to load as much weight on the bar as you would with the straight bar. Overall, the Kimbered squat bar is gonna be the most different squat experience you're gonna feel of these three bars. It is a wider bar at top, so it is gonna alleviate shoulder pain. It doesn't have any knurling, so I think that's why you'll see some people wrap the top of the bar with like sports tape so that it'll stay in place. I don't have an issue with it slipping or anything. I do notice, however, that when I do place my hands on the sides and even lower on the bars, then that's kind of when I feel it move a bit on me. So maybe that's why, because most people that I do see use the sports tape on the bars, their hands aren't placed on the straight bar. It's more on the sides of the Kimbered bar. So that could be why. Not sure, but anyhow, those are just my two cents. Now with the Kimbered bar, you're not gonna get any spin on like the collars. Like, it's just, they stay in place. They won't spin. So it seems like that's on purpose. Not really sure why. I'd have to look into it. Hopefully this video helps. Again, I just wanted to showcase the differences of what it's like to squat with a straight bar versus a buffalo bar versus a Kimbered squat bar. If you have any questions or whatnot that I missed here, please make sure to leave them in the comments and I'll try and get back to you as soon as possible. Thanks again for watching. This is your boy LJ, and I'll catch you next time.